God. The agent of death that's under God beside you. Thank you for this moment in time. Thank you for showing the God you know everything. The all-knowing God. You know all we have. You know what is going to happen every minute. You know what is going to happen today. Lord Jesus, we bless you. We worship, we adore you. Thank you for your children, O Lord. Thank you, Savior, for your people who are able to be here today. It's not by accident, O Lord God Almighty. It is a planting that you have already done, O Lord, in heaven. Father, we thank you. We believe and we know that you are here with us, O Lord Almighty, O Lord, to give us a surprise packet, O Lord. To answer all our penny prayers, it's going to be answered today in the name of Jesus. Amen. My Father, my God, have assured that you are here with us, O Lord, to bless us this morning. To bless us this morning, my Father, let the anointing come from you, O Lord, not from any human being. And so, Father, Lord God Almighty, I surrender myself unto the authority of you, Lord God Almighty, that whatever I'm going to say here today, let it come from you, Father. Let it come from you, God Almighty. Feed us, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. My Father, my God, that is better from you. All I want to see is only you, Jesus. No human being, my Father, but you want to hear from the throne of grace. We want to hear from you, Father. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, God, for your blessing that you're going to shower on us today in the mighty name of Jesus. Father, we give you praise. We bless you, Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we pray.
Amen.
Our God is a living God. It is a privilege to stand in front of you today. It is a real privilege. It is not human. Who am I? It's just mere human being who doesn't even know right from left. But God said he can use anything. God said he can use anything. If human being refuse to worship God, to serve God, he's ready to use some. To use any things. Why don't we surrender all our resources to God Almighty for him to use us? My brother and sister, I'm here because God said I should do it. And I know he said I should do it. He called me. I cannot call myself. I'm nothing. I'm just nothing. But when he said, do it, Son of God. Twice was you here. When God said move, you have to move. Father, I thank you.
Lord,
I will not take your prayer for granted. Lord Jesus, I know it is you. It is not my own making. Left to me, you know me more than I know myself. Father, I thank you. Thank you, Lord, for making me to subdue this flesh and to answer and to be able to stand in front of your children today. Father, I give you all the glory. All the praise is yours forever and ever in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
Thank you, Lord. Today is a glorious Sunday. A real glorious Sunday. We are going to be blessed today.
Amen.
God is going to speak to us today.
Amen.
Father, I thank you.
Thank you,
I bless you.
Amen.
I've got a short, just a simple message from God Almighty.
Amen.
To us and to me, to every one of us.
Hallelujah.
It will be just a certain. When I was praying, God, I was having so many things on my hand. But all of a sudden, I just finished studying. Starting studying. Then I was praying. And I've had it before. I think I've had it when I was back to Nigeria. When a pastor message based on pray on this, starting and studying. Then I said, God, where will I stand for this passage to preach on? I got so many passages in my mind. You just be worried, just like thinking for yourself. You say, I need to preach. So I've not been praying before. I've not been preaching before. I just want something that we make people as it. God said no. It's good to listen to God. When God say move, you have to move. Totally. I was praying, waiting for God. God Almighty. What will I tell your people? What will I speak to your children? Who am I able to stand in front of them saying, talking of God, a sinner, a bloody one? God, help me. Who cannot even speak? Hey, I say, Father, I've done it before. I think I've stand on here to preach about one or two times before. This making it the third time. Father, this is you. You have to do it again. Again and again. Father, I give you all the praise, O Lord.
Amen.
So the topic is certain and sudden. Can we go to 2 Peter 3:9-18. 2 Peter 3:9-18. And I want everybody to open the Bible and follow me with it. 3:9-19. Are we there? 3:9-19. The Lord is not slack concerning his promises, as some can slackness, but is long suffering toward us, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. Our Lord is not slack, as some people might be thinking, but is long suffering toward us, not willing that any should perish, but that all should come to repentance. Thank you, Jesus. 10. But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in which the heaven will pass away with a great noise, and the elements will melt with fervent heat. Both the heart and the works that are in men will be burned up. 11. Therefore, since all these things will be dissolved, what manner of person ought you to be in holy conduct and godliness? Therefore, since all these things will be dissolved, what manner of person ought you to be in holy conduct and godliness? 12. Looking for and hastening the coming of the day of God, because of which the heaven will be dissolved, being on fire, and the element will melt with fervent heat. 13. Nevertheless, we, according to his promise, look for new heavens and new earth in which righteousness dwells. Nevertheless, we, according to his promise, look for new heaven and a new earth in which righteousness dwells. 14. Therefore, beloved, looking forward to these things, be diligent to be found in him in peace, without spots and blameless. Be diligent to be found in him in peace, without spots and blameless. 15. And consider that the long suffering of our Lord is salvation, as also our beloved brother Paul, according to the wisdom given to him, has written to you. As also in all his episodes, speaking in them of these things, in which as some things are hard to understand, which unthought and unstable people twist to their own destruction, as they do also the rest of Scripture. 17. You therefore, beloved, since you know this beforehand, beware lest you also fall from your own steadfast. You therefore beware, lest you also fall from your own steadfastness, being led away with the error of the wicked. 18. But grow in the grace and knowledge of our Lord and Savior Jesus Christ. To him be the glory, both now and forever. Amen. Lord, we worship you. Father, we give you praise, O Lord. We thank you, Lord, for your word today. Thank you, King Eternal, for your way to take us through and open our eyes to see more of you today in the name of Jesus. When I went to the dictionary, I saw Saturn. I want to know, we all know the meaning of Saturn. It's just to body up. I said, Saturn, I want to know you more. Saturn dictionary means positive and confident. Then I went straight to certainty too. It's a state of being sure, something that is inevitable. A state of being sure, something that is inevitable. Then I went to look at sudden too, because the fact is certain and sudden. Sudden means done or occurring quickly and unexpectedly. What has would happen unexpectedly? That happened quickly and unexpectedly without giving any notice. Without making us to know that, oh, this thing is coming. Suddenly, it just come unexpectedly. Blessed be God forever. Then going through the text of this thing, there are so many things that we have read that is even certain, that we are assured that is bound to happen. Vital events that are bound to happen. One of them is, it is even imminent, that is very certain. The second coming of our Lord Jesus Christ. It is certain that Jesus Christ is coming back again. His second coming, it is certain. There's no doubt in that. And it will come, and it surely come. In Jesus' name.
Amen.
And since it is certain that Christ will serve, is a loving God. The Father will serve is a loving God. It is also certain that this God do not want us to perish. It's in that death that I read. But all should come to the parents. Father did not want any of us to perish. That is why he sent his only begotten Son to come on the cross to die for us. So that one is certain that God loves us. Even more than we love him. So it is certain that Christ, our Lord Jesus Christ, is a loving Father, and he never wants anybody to die. So he wants us to come to repentance, to accept him fully, to accept him and not to doubt him at all in any way of our life. So that one is certain that he first loves us. We bless the Lord, the name of the Lord. It is equally certain that everyone shall stand. In fact, I admit, I would have even said that Dickie Feyi has all preached all my preaching today. It is only quite certain that every one of us will stand before the judgment seat of Christ. It is in the Bible. It is very, very certain. One other thing that is so certain is that the second coming of Christ Jesus, the second coming will be sudden, unnoticed. It will come. It is certain that it's coming. And it's coming will be sudden. So how prepared are we for the coming of our Lord Jesus Christ? Are we one leg in or one leg out? Because it's certain. It's written in the Bible that his second coming will just be like a thief. We have just written it out through us on notice. What would my father met you doing? Will you stand? Will you be able to be in the right place at the right time? Children of God, we need to be thinking about this. Our God is good. Maybe you look at 2 Peter again, 3:10. Let's go through it. 2 Peter 3:10. But the day of the Lord will come as a thief in the night, in which the heaven will pass away with a great noise, and the element will melt with fervent heat, both the head and the work that are hid will burn up. That tells you that it's certain of the second coming, that will come and it will be sudden. Father, have mercy upon us. We don't want to miss you, God Almighty. Let us be at the right place at the right time. Thank you, Jesus. And there's a dear names at this point in time. From us to shun air, to avoid the air, a dear name for us to say no to hell fire. We are not part of you. We are for Christ Jesus, no other God. So children of God, we should always put it in mind that the coming of God is real, and it will come, and it will be sudden, unnoticed. It will be sudden, so we need to be prepared at every time for his coming. My father is coming back again. That is true. That is real. That is certain. That is going to come suddenly. You see the children of God following him, and it will be left with all the dark thoughts.
Those who refuse to accept Christ as their Lord and Savior. So it is certain,
and it is coming, and it's coming with sudden. Lord will give you praise.
Amen.
Father will thank you. We should be ever conscious at every moment in our life.
Amen.
So that we can reign with Christ at his second coming. And what do we need? 2 Peter 3:14. Let's go through it again. 2 Peter 3:14 said, therefore, beloved, looking forward to these things, be diligent to be found in him, in peace, without spots and blameless. Be diligent to be found in Christ. It is equally, it is required of us to be sensitive to the Spirit. We have to subdue this flesh. We have to subdue this spirit, this flesh. The Spirit of God is real, so that we can be able to listen to what our God really wants of us. The flesh always does allow us. We have to subdue to the flesh, because it's coming back again. It's true. It's real. And it's going to be sudden. Father, we thank you. So we have to learn to walk in love. We have to walk in love and pursue peace with all men. As a child of God, we have to be doing what God is doing. Our Christ going about doing good things. He never said this one is not mine. Oh, this one is not from my religion. Even the Christian among us, because you are not of the same religion, you still doubt them. What should you? Who can you do to say you need to doubt a person? Maybe from anyone. In my own, we can open and say that anything. We are children of God. We don't have to judge anybody. Let Christ judge us. We walk towards Christ. Then, not to talk of other religion that are not calling Christian, that are not calling Christ. Some people, they don't want to listen to them. We just need to walk in love. When they see the love of God in you, see the way you have with your Christ, that Christ in you, they will be following you. If you refuse to make friends with them, how will you preach to them? How will you show them the light of God that is in you? So, children of God, there's a dear need for us to befriend them, show them love. Let them see the true Christ where we belong. Definitely, your body to preach Christ, your attitude, preach Christ to your neighbor. The way you relate to them, preach Christ to everybody around you. Not that when we say, oh, we have to be only my church, surely the church do what they know. That come to your church, they are your best ones. Make friends with them. You'll be fine when they were, when, or during discussion, during anything, they will know who you are. And the light of God will shine and you will radiate to them. So children of God, we should be prepared and diligent to whatever that you are doing in Christ Jesus. God will help us in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Thank you, Jesus. We bless you. We need to be diligent in evangelism. We need to be diligent in evangelism. For if there's any time that we need to do this now, it's now. This is now the right time for us to let people know that Christ the Lord is coming back again. Let the light of the gospel radiate from you and to the unbeliever around you. It is the right time that we need to tell about Christ to everybody. That is one thing that we need to be diligent in doing. Thank God for this, the preach. I'm still waiting for another Saturday that they are going to call upon us, that we need to go out to preach the gospel. We need to do it individually. We need to go out as a church and in one accord to look for the lost one of Christ, because God loves every one of us. We are all his children. He never wants anybody to perish. So we that have known this, let's go out. Let them know that our Father don't want anybody to perish, but to be in love, but to show love, and to accept him, and to serve him. That is the purpose of our living. So, children of God, more of evangelism in the kingdom of God. We want it. It is now, in the right time. Amen. Because many things are going all over the world. So, we need to preach Christ. We need to let people know. Father, we thank you. We bless you, Lord. Thank you, Savior, for a day like this, O Lord God Almighty. We believe that you are going to help us. Father, you are going to stand by us. You are going to help us, O Lord, even to be steadfast in you. You are going to make it possible for us, O Lord. We need to be steadfast. We need to be steadfast, children of God. In working for God, we need to stand and be steadfast in doing his word. We need to be steadfast in doing the word of God. We should stop following all these mundane things in the world, in the internet, listen to anything. Get straight to God Almighty. Be prepared at any time. Avoid all this unnecessary that we do. In Facebook, in any social work, everything. We have to reduce it and spend more time with the Word of God. So that we know the right things, we know the right school, right, the right route, the right step to take at any time. If this Word of God will edify us, our body, and we remain committed to the gospel. And lastly, we need to be expectant. Despite the fact that we believe God for a length of days, it is expected of us to live expectantly. To live expectantly of his coming. And having the fact, establishing the fact that Jesus Christ is coming soon. Oh, it is required for us to be ready, my dear sister and brother. To be ready at any point in time for Christ. My Father is coming and he's coming and he will call. His second coming will be sudden. So we need to live. Be expectant of every day. Be ever conscious. Forget about just this of life. Enough, he has promised that whoever has served him diligently is going to bless the person. Only do to remind the God Almighty of his promises. My Father will do it.
Amen.
We will not lack any good things on us. He will answer all our prayer. All our penny prayer, God Almighty will bring it to pass in the name of Jesus.
Amen.
The light radiates in us. Let other people know what's what. Let them see it in us. Let's go out. Some life are perishing outside there. Brother and sister, who have never even heard this word of God. Befriend them. I learned of recent, just last week, that how can a man commit suicide? Because they take away your children from you. When the King of the Lord of God is there, when you kneel down your closest, they will be begging you to come and take your children away. How can you just commit suicide because of that when we are serving and living God? So many people are really far from God. They are friends and we didn't know. We hit with them, we go to social with them, but still they don't know God. Because I was so shocked when I heard that breaking news. Because they collect your children. They don't come near me. Yes, many people have been doing this. Why do you serve God? Why are you a child of God? He never promised us a rosy life. Yes, problem will come. But we are going to win.
Amen.
At any time. All we need is to accept him and believe in him. That he's able to do more abundantly, more than what we able. What we even think of. Father will do it for us. Children of God. Only believe in him. Only accept him fully into your heart. And stop doubting God works. Stop doubting, can you do it? Can you do it? Stop using your brain. Because if you continue using brain with the word of God, you won't believe God. Because how can this happen? How can this happen? It will surely happen because it's written in the Bible. Because my Father said so. He's not a dead for a father. He's a living God.
Yes.
He sees everything. He knows that thing is coming. But how? Please, all the body and everything. Let's hand it over to God Almighty.
Amen.
Depression, what is it? Sickness? Illness? Savior is enough. He has died because of Calvary. To set me and you free. Which he has set us free. And whoever child of God is child of God is free indeed. Believe me, you have been free. You have been free. Only for you. All that you need is in the Holy Bible. Sit down and seek for it. Not only your pastor doing it for you. Read it daily. Let me a manual in your hand. That's a manual for us, children of God. Pray every day. And believe in God. Seek his face daily. Have time with God. With the thing of the world that is going up and down does not make us to have enough time. We just have to create the time. We need to create time in praying. We need our self time that we just have to go into to that word, you will be blessed. I never see anybody dealing with the Bible daily. That is not at peace. No way. Just ask the Holy Spirit, I'm going through your word. Teach me of your word. Believe me, that particular place that you need, the Spirit of God will direct you to the place. And you see the answer to that you need. The peace will come from above. There is a solution to whatever you want in Jesus' name. Our Father is free. Jesus Christ is free. He's coming back. It is certain. And that his coming will be sudden, unexpectedly. So, children of God, we need to prepare, be ready. Thank you, faithful God, for today's teaching. My God, my Father, I give you all the glory, all the praises, all the honor is yours. Thank you for reminding us again that your coming, second time coming, is going to be sudden. And we need to prepare to get ready at all time. Savior, you know us more than you know ourselves, my Father, my God. I pray, O Lord, that we not stand this today, that you not stand in front of all that. Oh, you've had it before. Haven't you? We make use of it in the name of Jesus, O Lord. And we stand by you. And we believe you, Lord God Almighty, that we do your own pass in keeping us, O Lord, my Father. In meeting all our needs, miraculous, O Lord God Almighty. Our hearts are on you. Because I know all that we need in life, O Lord. We want to make it, don't want to lose you, O Lord. We want to make heaven in the name of Jesus, O Lord. Lord, we thank you. Father, we believe you. Father, we bless you. Thank you, Savior. No other God beside you, O Lord. Thank you, Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Amen.
Father is a good God.
All the time.
Thank you, Jesus Christ. Just need a prayer, just one or two prayers. Time is gone. Lord, that's a prayer point. Help me not to be a victim of any form of end time disease. Let's pray it that we should not be a victim of any time disease in Jesus' name. My Father, my God, I pray that we should not be any time end time disease in the name of Jesus. Father, help us in Christ evangelism that we will not be a victim of any form of any time disease in Jesus' name. Savior, we thank you. We bless you. Thank you, Father. Father, God, God Almighty, uproot every planting of devil in my life. It's a prayer that we need to pray. Every planting of devil in our life, let God Almighty uproot it now in the name of Jesus. Lord God Almighty, I commit that same my sacrifice unto you. Every planting of the devil in my life, uproot it in Jesus' name. In Jesus' mighty name we pray. And the last prayer is let's pray for our Father in the Lord, the general overseer of Christ Divine Church. Ask God Almighty that God has set aside a name for God to complete it in the name of Jesus. We have prayed this morning, we will continue to pray and we continue to pray. My Father, perfect our Father in the Lord in the name of Jesus. Let him be whole completely in the name of Jesus, O Lord. When he's coming back with fresh oil, fresh anointing, and option to perform in the name of Jesus, O Lord. Father, we give you praise. Father, we bless you. Thank you, Savior, for there's no other God beside you. Thank you for answering our prayer always, O Lord. Thank you, Savior, for it is well with our children, O Lord. In our number ever be heard. It is well with them, O Lord. Your eyes, our eyes are on you, and your eyes are on them for us. In the mighty name of Jesus, O Lord. Thank you, Savior. We thank God for the joining mercy from them when it's time for them to call. In the name of Jesus. We bless you, Savior. We love you, Lord God Almighty. There's no other God beside you. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Savior. From north to south, there is no other God. No other one. In the name of Jesus. Deacon Faye, please. Come and close the service.